What's going on, my motherfucking Virgos? It's your good sis, LavaTheEmpress, and for those who are new to my channel, I get that spiritual tea and see what's going on in your life, yada yada. Now, this reading is going to be a little different. This is going to be how do people view you, and what is it that you're not noticing about yourself? Let's get right into it, motherfucking. I was about to call you Scorpio. Damn, you could be dealing with a Scorpio though, with somebody that has Scorpio in their chart, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or Capricorn, or Sagittarius, or yeah. But anyway, how do people view you? People view you as somebody who is definitely, we have Child Eternal here. Somebody who can see things with a fresh set of eyes, like. You have the ability to see things in all different types of perspectives here, and you are very in tune with yourself, or you have the ability to be in tune with yourself. People see you as somebody who is divine, somebody who is very pure and innocent. And maybe not all of you Virgos are pure and innocent, so let's be real, but you do have that energy about you. I feel like you do have great intentions when it comes to people or whatever, but some of you definitely sabotage certain things on purpose. People do view you as somebody who self-sabotage or knows how to sabotage a situation or fuck up a situation. This is just how people view you. So if you don't feel like that about yourself, it is what it is. That's how they view you. Now, what you're not noticing about yourself. Also, hold on. Let me see something. So I forgot to, let me see. How do people view... Okay, and what is it my Virgos are not noticing about themselves? Okay, got it. Yeah, people view you as someone who self-sabotage. Maybe you get a little depressed sometimes, randomly. You just get depressed or whatever, and you just don't want to be bothered sometimes. Shit. Yeah, you could be a little impatient. All right, so some of my Virgos, what you don't realize about yourself is that sometimes you like to rush situations instead of being patient. And some of you out there are being a little too patient and waiting on something instead of taking action. So you take it how it resonates. You either being a little too patient or you're not being patient at all. But I feel like that's going to balance itself out in the end. Mm-hmm. You are somebody who take things, like, especially if it's material, your materialistic side, like, you take care of your stuff. You definitely take care of your stuff. You treat your stuff with care, or you handle things with care. You know what I'm saying? You're very careful when it comes to your personal items, or even with money or whatever the case may be. Like, you take good care. Probably not with money, but either way, you take good care, okay, of your material aspects. I feel like you may feel like you are a little judged sometimes, or maybe you can come off a little judgmental. Overall, you definitely, there's success and abundance here for you guys. So if you're worried about anything, just know that it's on its way. People see you as very abundant as well. So you may not have $100,000 in your bank, or $100 million in your bank, but that $1,000 that you do have, that $500 that you do have, is more than what this person has, or more than what most people have right now. And so people are looking at you as someone who is abundant, even when you don't realize it within yourself. Yeah, you guys are definitely someone who... Now, what you don't notice about yourself is, I don't know if you guys write. I think you guys are great writers. You maybe rap, or you're in the artistic whatever field, or you just have a knack for music, or you just know how to place your words when it comes. Maybe some of you write books, or whatever the case may be. Maybe you need to write a book. Maybe you don't know that one of your greatest strengths is in the form of writing. So get up on it. Write a poetry book, whatever the case may be. Get up on it though. I feel like you guys, some of you may play victim sometimes to situations, but other of you, you don't play victim. You just like, you know what, it is what it is. I've done this. This is what happened, and it was because of me. It was my fault. I feel like you guys definitely take that initiative when you're wrong, to say that you're wrong. Like, you know that you're wrong, so you'll be like, you know what, that was my fault, it was my bad. Some of you do take that victim role, though, and be like, you know what, this did happen to me, and whatever, it's this person's fault. But I feel like for most of my Virgos out there, you take the initiative, because you are very nurturing. Some of you can have a child here, or have children, but yeah, you are definitely nurturing, wow. You are definitely nurturing, okay? Nurturing. You give unconditional love. People notice you for your unconditional love here as well. There's something about sabotage energy. Maybe you feel like you're not good enough sometimes. Maybe, yeah, you don't have enough sometimes, and maybe you'll fuck around and sabotage a situation based off that thought alone. Yeah, there's a need to understand that when you lose something, that is just an opportunity to appreciate it for when it happened and move on, okay? Some of you have suffered a lot of grief here. Some of you have lost a person recently. You lost someone. I'm sorry for your loss. But also letting go of what no longer serves you here. So, yeah, definitely that's what I'm seeing here. Let's get some channeled messages. I don't mean for this to be too short, but it's really straight to the point. And yeah, I will be doing another video on, you know, love and my regular degular stuff. I just wanted you guys to see this. But let's get the channeled messages. Okay. Channeled message we have here is reconciliation, past is coming back. So maybe there's a lot of things in the past that you still need healing from, that is still off balance, or maybe there's something that you need to really let go. But either way, you'll get that opportunity to get that closure or whatever it is that you're looking for in order to remove yourself from this energy of feeling sad or whatever the case may be. Or feeling the need to self-sabotage in a situation. I feel like the past is definitely coming back to give you some healing. So that's what I'm seeing from my Scorpios here. I said Scorpios. Wow, why I keep saying Scorpios? You guys could be dealing with the Scorpio, or your North Node could be in Scorpio, whatever the case may be. Virgo, it's your good sis, Lava the Empress, and I'll see you in your next video. Bye, Virgos.